Our Los Angeles Lakers boys fought bravely for a while. Hi all Los Angeles Lakers fans. Welcome to the Los Angeles Lakers news channel. All the information you need to know daily to stay up to date. So you Lakers fans can relax and enjoy our content. Subscribe to the channel and turn on the bell. So you won't miss all the Los Angeles Lakers news. And we begin. Grizzlies All-Stars power Memphis to 121-109 win over depleted the Lakers. At the end of the day, it was probably unrealistic to expect LA to actually hold on long enough to beat the West second-seeded Memphis Grizzlies in Memphis without all-star forward LeBron James or starting point guard D'Angelo Russell, the club's third leading scorer. But things stayed close for a while, with Los Angeles actually leading at the halftime break behind some stellar bench scoring and the solid two-way play of Anthony Davis. The Lakers trotted out a new temporary starting five of Dennis Schroeder, Malik Beasley, Troy Brown Jr., Jared Vanderbilt and Anthony Davis. The Grizzlies led, just barely, 26-22, after a quarter. LA shot a meager 35% from the floor in the first quarter, while Davis already seemed well on his way to yet another double-double, with 5 points and 7 boards. In an interesting wrinkle, Wenyen Gabriel supplanted Mo Bamba as Darvin Ham's reserve center of choice behind AD, with Bamba only getting 1:15 of spot time at the end of the game. Backup LA shooting guard Lonnie Walker IV, reinvigorated by his return to the team's rotation, instantly started draining triples in the second frame. Walker also had the highlight of the game with a throwback Skywalker-type slam. The Grizzlies shot 0 for 12 during that LA run. Memphis quickly got right back into it, thanks in part to 15 Lakers turnovers overall in the first half. A 7-0 Lakers close to the quarter gave LA a 49-46 first half edge heading into the break. Davis had 8 points on 2 of 5 shooting from the field, 10 boards and 4 blocks, already making this his 15th game with 3 blocks this year for Los Angeles. But the big story for LA through 2 quarters was its bench play. Reeves led all Lakers scorers with 15 points on 4 of 5 shooting from the field, all triples, and 3 of 3 shooting from the charity stripe, 2 assists, 2 rebounds and a steal. Through the game's first 2 quarters, Walker was the team's second leading scorer with 10 points on 3 of 7 shooting from the floor, 2 of 4 from deep, 2 rebounds and a block. The Lakers went on a 13-3 run between the end of the second quarter and the opening minutes of the third to build a 55-49 lead. Morant woke up in the third period, scoring 28 points in that frame alone after having scored just 4 points in the game's first half. Morant landed awkwardly on his right elbow and had to be helped to his feet near the end of the quarter, but ultimately did return to the game in the fourth. Memphis outscored LA 47-33 to end the third quarter up 93-84. Things remained chippy and somewhat close through about the midway point of the game's first half. Desmond Bane and Jaren Jackson Jr. finally got humming at this point and helped extend the Grizzlies' lead. It hovered around low double digits the rest of the way until Darvin Ham finally sub-bet out his rotation guys at the 1:15 mark. Morant finished with a 39-point, 10-rebound, 10-assist triple-double in just 33-45. Jackson had 16 points on 7 of 14 shooting and grabbed 7 boards, and substitute starting center Xavier Tillman notched an 18-point, 11-board double-double. Davis was the Lakers' MVP of the night, scoring 28 points on 9 of 19 shooting, pulling down 19 rebounds, and notching 5 blocks. The Lakers' defense on Morant was pretty rough, but perhaps its biggest problem was its sloppy ball protection. LA had a whopping 26 turnovers, 9 more than Memphis. The Grizzlies also massively outscored the Lakers 86-48 in the paint. One positive wrinkle for LA was the superlative performance of Walker, reactivated into LA's lineup thanks to the injuries to Russell and James. In just 22 minutes, Walker had 21 points on 7 of 15 shooting from the floor, 5 of 10 from long range. 4 rebounds, an assist and a block. LA will get another chance to get a win sans LeBron James tomorrow night against the Oklahoma City Thunder.